हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com/DrVet चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर इन हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। हियर वी डिस्कस इम्पोर्टेंट बैक्टीरियल डिजीज एंट्रोटॉक्सिमिया टाइप ए, एंड इन पार्ट टू वी विल डिस्कस पैथोजेनेसिस, क्लिनिकल साइंस, डायग्नोसिस, ट्रीटमेंट एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ एंट्रोटॉक्सिमिया टाइप ए। फ्रेंड्स, वी डिस्कस हियर पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ एंट्रोटॉक्सिमिया टाइप ए। डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाय क्लोस्ट्रिडियम परफ्यूजन्स टाइप ए एंड इट प्रोड्यूस ए पोटेंट अल्फा टॉक्सिन which is responsible for causing pathogenesis and disease. Alpha toxin possesses phospholipase and sphingomyelinase, and it causes hemolytic action in the animal. So it causes serious consequences, hemolysis of the blood. Continue pathogenesis. The important alpha toxin, it possesses hemolytic lecithinase, that is phospholipase, and sphingomyelinase activity. This causes serious consequences in animal, that is myonecrosis, necrosis of the muscle, and hemolysis of the blood. This is characterized by a clinical manifestation, severe hemolysis and jaundice in animal. So the synonym of the disease is yellow lamb disease, because the carcass of the lamb become yellowish because of the jaundice. Continue with the pathogenesis. The organism also produce beta 2 toxin, and this produce a pathogenicity and causes symptoms, high temperature, jaundice, mucous membrane, and hemoglobinuria. These are the consequence of the hemolysis. In cattle, it develops jejunal hemorrhagic symptom, a hemorrhage in the jejunal portion of the small intestine. In most of the animal, it produce necrotic enteritis. In this, there is a massive destruction of the villi of the intestine and coagulation necrosis of the small intestine, which is responsible for many symptoms, syndrome, and death of the animals. Clinical signs of enterotoxemia type A. In horse, it causes acute profuse diarrhea with high motility in adult, and death occurs following a strenuous exercise. In pigs, mostly piglets less than 5 days of age are affected. There is enteritis manifested by watery yellow diarrhea. The disease causes high morbidity and low fatality rate. Clinical signs in cattle, sheep and goats. There is a hemorrhagic enteritis in calf and adult cattle. There is severe hemorrhage in the feces and causes dysentery with blood in the feces. Hemolytic disease in sheep and goat. It is also a serious consequence. on destruction of the hemoglobin, there is jaundice, disease is highly fatal, and so the carcass is yellowish, jaundice or ictus. So disease is synonymed as yellow lamb disease. Necropsy finding of enterotoxemia type A. In horse, cicatitis and colitis. In pigs, mild enterocolitis and villus atrophy is observed. Necropsy findings in cattle, sheep and goat. In cattle, sheep and goat, it produces hemolytic disease and hemorrhagic enterotoxemia. So, necropsy finding is according. The mucous membrane becomes jaundiced, kidney swollen, dark brown in color, and contain infarcts. The liver is pale and enlarged. There is hydropericardium and pulmonary edema. And characteristic is extensive necrosis of the intestine. Diagnosis of enterotoxemia type A. Isolation and identification of organism from the feces. Identification of toxin in feces, enterotoxin gene, and it may cause a protease degradation. Cytotoxic assay and immunoassay for the toxin. Culture of organism from the feces is not sufficient to confirm the diagnosis of disease because this Clostridium perfringens type A is the normal inhibitant of the intestine of the animals. So, simply culture of organism from the feces is not sufficient to confirm the diagnosis. Continue with the diagnosis. We know that simply identification of the organism in feces is not a confirmatory diagnosis. So, to obtain a true and confirmed diagnosis, the cultural results should be confirmed with characteristic clinical signs, lesions in the tissue, and toxin identification. All this will help to confirm the diagnosis. Generally, tissue samples from the calves or other animal should be collected immediately after death and it is preserved for the diagnosis. Friend, here we discuss treatment of enterotoxemia type A. Specific treatment is antitoxin along with the antibiotics. Most of the cases cure with this. Tetracycline, sulfa groups of drugs, sulfa drugs in combination with trimethoprim, or any higher antibiotic or broad spectrum antibiotic will also help. The symptomatic treatment according to the symptoms, treatment of hemolysis, treatment of hemorrhagic enteritis, diarrhea, dysentery, jaundice, high temperature, and dehydration correction will help in early recovery and better results. Here we throw the light on prevention and control of enterotoxemia type A. The prevention of enterotoxemia caused by Clostridium perfringens infection focuses on mainly three areas. The first area is management of feeding practices, a very important, because the organisms are normal inhabitant of the digestive tract. So if the management of feeding practices is proper, the proliferation of Clostridium perfringens will be prevented. So important part is management of feeding practices. Continuation, prevention and control. The first principle, management of feeding program. Second principle, minimize exposure of the infection to the animal. The various ways are hygiene and sanitation, disinfection of the premises, reduction of stress, isolation of the infected animal, proper disposal of the infected material. This will minimize the exposure to the animal. The third principle is enhancement of immunity, especially in young calf. Type A serum provides ready-made antibody and that neutralizes the toxin. It is very effective to prevent the disease in the calf, and the antibody can be increased by giving the formaldehyde vaccine if available or if required. Friends, we discuss here pathogenesis, clinical findings, diagnosis, treatment and control, important aspect of enterotoxemia type A. Requested to share this information to veterinary friends and veterinary students. To promote the channel, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.